Hey everyone, welcome back. I'm really appreciative that you're here, ready to flow with me. We are going over yoga basics part two. So if you have not done part one, no worries, you can still follow along with this class. I would recommend going back to the first yoga basics so that you can kind of get to know what we're saying a little bit more in this class and just start to build your foundation for yoga. Foundation is super, super important so that you can start to get a little bit deeper into your practice and start to enhance your poses, your body, mind-body connection, all of that. So in the first video, we talked about ujjayi breath, the pranayama within the body, and the importance of breathing within your class. We went over our modified sun salutation A, as well as a little bit of a modified sun salutation B. So we're gonna go through that again, go through our vinyasa flow, right, which is a sequence that you see a lot in vinyasa classes. And then we're building a little bit more today. Today we will cover a little bit more asanas, poses, such as warrior two, and the anatomical placement within warrior two, as well as trikonasana, triangle pose. So that's virabhadrasana, warrior two, and trikonasana, triangle pose, as well as potentially one more depending on the timing, but we are gonna go over the chaturanga dandasana again, and down dog again, adho mukha svanasana. So let's get started. We'll start in child's pose, balasana, toes together, knees apart. So if you have bad knees, you can always double up your mat or bring a blanket on underneath your knees or whatever it is that you need to do to find comfort in your body. So when you're ready, balasana, child's pose, toes together, knees apart. So the first part of class, we'll kind of flow it out since we've already gone over some of these poses, and then we'll break down a little bit more. Start to notice your breath. Notice your body. Letting yourself ground down into the earth, letting the hips melt down. The knees are not open too much. They're a smaller V. That way you can give your body time to relax and settle in. Start to notice your breath, your ujjayi breath. Inhaling through the nose. Deep exhales out of the nose. Maybe even a cleansing breath to start. Open up and exhale. And start to activate your ujjayi breath, ocean sounding breath. You guys stay down. I'm going to come up so I can talk. Ujjayi, ocean sounding breath. Big inhale through the nose. Expand through the backside of the body. Expand through the front side, through your heart. Feel yourself energizing with this vital breath. In and out, nice and slow. Try to get your exhales to be a little bit longer than your inhales. Allowing them to detox the body as you breathe in with life force, vitality, and fresh oxygen. You exhale out, detoxifying the body, allowing the body to find space for the beautiful breath. And this breath will guide you through the rest of the practice. Try not to move until you finish and complete your cycle of breath before you move on to your next asana, your next pose. Ujjayi breath, start to rock the hips side to side. Now you might feel a little bit of a stretch here in your quads. Come up just a bit if you need, or just stay down. Look up towards the front of your mat, start to shift forward into tabletop position, drawing the knees underneath the hips. Drawing the belly button in, palms are flat, shoulder distance. Spread the fingertips wide and start to open up the chest. Inhale, gaze high, tailbone tilts to the sky. As you exhale, like someone's tickling you in the belly, start to round the spine in, drop the head down. Inhale, open up the heart. Exhale, round in. Open up the heart. Feel the fingertips spread. Feel the heart open up. Feel the tailbone tilt as you inhale for your cow pose. As you exhale, start to round in. Let the head go. Belly button strong. Tailbone tucks down this time for your cat pose. Let's take this three more times. Inhale, lift. Exhale, round. Inhale. Pressing the tops of the feet, pressing the knuckles of the index finger. Exhale. Last one, inhale. Exhale, round. Hold your rounded spine. Flip your toes behind you. We're just going to shift back to stretch the backs of the feet. Shift forward, shift back. Take this a couple of rounds, shifting forward, shifting back. Start to find your breath a little bit deeper in and out of the nose. Hold back, pressing the heels up to the sky, stretching the backs of the feet. Start to shift forward. Now start to extend your right leg back. Gentle shift forward and back. We're just stretching the hamstring, stretching the calf, getting the body ready. And as you're doing this, you're shifting forward and back on your wrists, engaging through mobility, giving yourself some time to settle it. Slowly switch sides, left leg back, forward and back. Draw the belly in, start to find your bandhas. You remember those locks we talked about in the first class? Your bandhas are your energetic locks in the body. The first one is your root lock, the pelvic floor. So like you're holding your teen pole, we talked about that before. Then your second lock comes into your belly button. Go ahead and draw the knee down. Belly button comes into the spine, engaging towards the back of the body, and then tucking your ribcage in. While keeping your mula bandha, your root lock, and your belly button, uddiyana bandha. Slowly extend your right heel back, find your breath. Engage through the palms, broaden the shoulder blades, extend your left leg back, finding plank pose. Then careful not to lift the hips up, careful not to drop the hips down, right? It's a plank, so you're in one long line. From the crown of your head all the way down beyond the heels, breathe, ujjayi breath. Bend the knees, start to shift the hips back and up. Coming into our first down dog, just start to pedal up the feet, walk your dog. Make sure you're breathing, ujjayi breath. Come high to the heels, bend the knees. Slowly start to walk to the front of the mat, open up the legs nice and wide. I'm going to come to my side. You stay there. Legs come wide. Heels dig into the ground. Bend the knees. Grab opposite elbow. Relax the head. And just start to sway side to side. We're just letting the body open up. Letting the hamstrings open. Take a couple more breaths. A couple more rounds. Slowly release the palms. Option to use your block. Palms down. Take an inhale. Lengthen the spine. Lengthen the crown. Try not to crunch the neck. So we're never here. We're always lengthening through the back of the neck. Gaze is down. Bend the left knee nice and deep. Bend the right knee. Find your breath. Ujjayi. Slowly start to come back to center. Keep the knees softened. Release the block. If you have it, step your palms down. Step your feet back. Find your plank position. Inhale. Exhale. Bend the knees. Come back to your down dog. Now remember, you can always keep the knees bent. Shoulder blades down and back. Core stays strong. Heels continue to draw downward. Even if your knees are bent, the heels are still drawing downward versus super high. Try to draw the shoulder blades away from the ears. Knuckle of your index fingers down to the ground. Belly button strong, core active. Rib cage knits in, start to find your breath. Let's just open up the body a bit more. High heels, bend the knees. Roll the spine up towards the front of your body and towards plank. Bend the knees, roll back. Starting to find a little bit of a fluid flow coming forward, rolling back. Bear to plank. Plank to bear. Find your breath. Take a few more rounds. And we'll start to set up our sun salutation A, modify. When you're ready, slowly start to step your feet up towards the front of your mat. Now this first one, maybe the knees stay bent. That's fine. Maybe the feet stay hip distance. That's also fine. Nice deep release of the head. On your inhale, hands to shins. Lengthen through the spine. Make sure we're not crunching up. Gaze is down for Ardha Uttanasana. Half forward fold. Exhale, Uttanasana forward fold. For the first one, bend the knees. Roll up one vertebrae at a time. As you inhale, reach the arms nice and high. Take a breath. Exhale, hands in a heart center. Now hold for a moment. In the first video, we talked about our feet grounding, lengthening through the body, out of the crown of the head, yes? You want to find that same sensation. You're drawing the belly button up and in. Try not to arch your spine. Tailbone releases, almost like an anchor down to the ground. Shoulder blades back, breathe. Hands are in prayer, Anjali Mudra. Ujjayi breath. On your inhale, arms reach high, Urva Hastasana. Bend the knees, hinge from the hips, flatten out the spine, exhale, forward fold, all the way down. Option for block, always. Inhale, lengthen, Ardha Uttanasana, gaze down. Bend the knees, step back, plank pose. Take an inhale. Coming into our first chaturanga, option to bring the knees down. We're just softening, remember? Then bend the elbows to a 90-degree angle, shoulder blades back. Try not to dumb forward. Stay strong. Shift forward, open the heart, kiss the shoulder blades together. Now your feet come behind you, try not to keep them wide. Cobra, so tails are slightly together. Breathe, inhale. Come through your tabletop, flip your toes, hips up and back. Exhale, down dog. Apa Mukha Svanasana. Inhale, high heels. Exhale, step it up, toes touch this time. Inhale, lengthen, Ardha Uttanasana, half lift. Spine is active, try not to round, keep the core strong. When you're ready, exhale to your forward fold. Option to bend the knees, inhale, reverse, swan dive, arms reach high. Exhale, hands in a heart center, hold, breathe. Take a couple moments here. Activate the body. Find your breath. Inhale, arms reach high. Urva Hastasana. Exhale, hinge from the hips forward. Full Uttanasana. Half lift, Ardha Uttanasana. Step back, plank position. This is called Uttita Chaturanga Dandasana. Hold. Exhale, bend the knees. Elbows to 90 degrees. Graze your side body. Open up the heart. Shift forward. Inhale. Bhujangasana, watch those shoulder blades, keep kissing them back. Try not to crunch here. We're gazing, the head is gazing forward, the eyes can gently gaze up. Come through your tabletop into down dog. Breathe, ujjayi breath, stay in down dog for just a moment. We're gonna do this three more times, flowing this out. I'm gonna speak less on the second and third so we can find our vinyasa flow, our modified sun salutation A. Ujjayi breath. Ears by the biceps, gaze in between the legs. Tailbone tilts to the sky. Your sternum, the center of your body, comes right in between towards your thighs. Ujjayi. Inhale, heel. Exhale, step it up, toes. Inhale, you still have the option to bend the knees. Exhale. Root to rise, option for flat back. Inhale. Hands to heart. Inhale, reach. Exhale, forward fold. Option to keep the knees bent. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, step back. This time, one swift movement. Option for knees, chaturanga. Heart open, shoulders kiss. Bhujangasana. Ardha Mukha Svanasana. Let's blow this out two more times. One breath per movement. On your next cycle of breath, inhale. You know where to go, muscle memory starts to kick in. Take your time, take your modifications. If you're ready to keep the legs straight, that's fine by me. One swift exhale to chaturanga, option to keep the knees up this time, maybe one knee comes down. Breathe. Last time. Inhales take you up, exhales take you down. Find child's pose and take a rest. If you're overheated because we've been moving, you can always exhale through your mouth, opening up. It's gonna release some heat out of the body, tapas, inner heat. If you'd rather keep heat within the body, then keep the mouth closed and just take a nice deep, a little bit more accentuated exhale out of the nose. Beautiful. Grab some water if you need it. I'm a huge water break kind of gal. Okay, moving on, adding into our flow, moving into a modified sun salutation B. We're skipping warrior A, warrior one in sun salutation B in ours. We're just kind of coming through to a low lunge. So we did this in the first class. Again, I would definitely recommend checking that out if you haven't checked it out already. Adho Mukha Svanasana. So remember, if you come to plank and you're nice and long, heels step over your toes, broaden up the shoulder blades. You're not short here, so we're not stacking the shoulders over the wrist. It's stacking right above the wrist, yes? If you're in a proper plank, then you should be able to come up and back into a proper down dog without having to shift the heels up or back. It's a proper down dog, from plank to down dog. Breathe. On your next inhale, right heel lifts, bend your knee, stack your hip. Now watch not to dump in your left shoulder. Keep pressing your shoulders to square. Belly button stays strong as you start to roll the right hip out. So you're drawing big circles on the right side, getting the joint lubricated here. Breathe. Continue pressing into your palms and drawing the core in. Try not to bend the elbows unless, of course, you're trying to find mobility, but really the elbow strong is best. Exhale, step it through as you're drawing the knee towards your chest, stepping through to a runner's lunge. Now, if you have blocks, this is a good time. We're going to stretch the right leg a bit. So bend the knees, straighten it out. Just take a few moments. If you don't have blocks, that's fine. I would recommend keeping your fingertips strong, never doing this little motion here. I don't know if you can see. This motion where you draw your fingertips down and then just the palm lifts is really, really bad for your wrist and for your fingers. So you're either in a cupcake palm or a tented palm, or you're completely flat. If you must be on a wrist, I would recommend not doing that unless you are a seasoned yogi, but you want to tuck your thumb in and not hug your thumb into your fingertips. If you have any questions about that, just leave me a comment and I'll respond. So straighten and bend. I like to use blocks. I feel like it enhances my practice. Breathe, ujjayi breath. Just whatever feels good here in this position, playing around, straightening and bending. You have one more breath. And then slowly start to find low lunge, anjani asana B. So your right hip draws back and the back knee comes down. You have the option to use blocks here as you start to lift your chest up. So I personally don't like the blocks here as much because then I shift forward. So what I do rather is just bring my hand right on top of my thigh and then draw my right hip back. Pressing into the front heel, roll the shoulders back. Anjani Asana B. On your inhale, reach the arms nice and high. Draw the shoulder blades down and let them melt into the back of the body. Ujjayi breath. Make sure the core is strong. This knee comes directly outside of the hip, so we're not splaying it. Keeping your left glute engaged to support your front psoas. Breathe. As you exhale, draw your left palm down, stacking your left shoulder over your left wrist, making sure that we're externally rotating. Flip your back toe up and lift your back knee. Extend the right arm high and rotate from your belly. Shoulder blades back. So you want an external rotation, not an internal here. Breathe. Easy twist. Swinging the arm to the back of the room, softening the back knee, step forward, toes touch. On your inhale, Utkatasana chair pose. Sitting low, toes together, knees together. Take an inhale, reach up with up to the sky. Make sure you're tucking your tailbone here. Heavy, heavy tailbone. Now check to see if you can see your toes. If you can't, sit back a little bit more. If you're shifted forward, you're not gonna be able to see your toes. You wanna pretend like you're sitting in a chair here. This is called fierce pose or chair pose. Utkatasana, breathe. You're starting to feel your legs fire up, inner thighs active. Creating heat, tapas, glutes strong. Take one more breath.
On your inhale, press down into the heels, stand tall. Exhale, hinge from the hips forward, fold. Let's switch sides. Half lift, bend the knees. Let's just step your right foot back all the way. Left leg kicks up towards the sky, bend the knees, stack your hip. Vama, left side. Big circles on your left, breathe. Press out of the right shoulder. Maybe go the opposite direction. Again, if you have the heel up and the knee bent, that's okay. We're starting to get into our bodies. The goal is to draw the heel down and the knee straight. Exhale, knee to nose, step it through. Runner's lunge. So you might even step here and then kind of just scoot your foot forward. That's fine. We're going to start somewhere, right? You don't just start flexing. You build to it. Block, straighten, bend. You have a couple breath. Explore the body. Ujjayi. When you're ready, runner's lunge, draw your left hip back, back knee comes down, hands to front thigh, Anjaneyasana. So what tends to happen here is you see this a lot, people want to kind of sit in this pose. That will cause so much serious damage into your front hip flexors, your psoas over time, and your knee goes over the ankle. You really want to have a support of your joint stack. So press into the front heel and shift back. Squeeze this right glute and keep the hips squared. Maybe bring the hands to your hips, make sure that they're squared. Shoulder blades down and back. So I have a little bit more room I can move to, but it depends on your body. Arms reach high, inhale, Anjaneyasana, B. In some yoga lineages, they call this something else. We're gonna call it Anjaneyasana, B. Breathe. On your exhale, easy twist, right palm down. Now I like to turn my palms slightly 45 so that my shoulder blade can activate externally rotated. My lat activates so that it draws my shoulder back. Flip your back toe, lift the knee, rotate from your obliques, easy twist. Keep drawing your hips to square, check your body. Left knee should come in towards your chest. Breathe, ujjayi breath, inhale. Swing your top arm to the back of the room. Soften the knees. Step forward. Toes touch. Inhale. Utkatasana. Chair pose. Second round. Maybe the hands come to hips. Feel your body. Is your belly button in? Can you tuck your ribcage in so we're not splaying out? Can you sit lower and see your tippy toes? Arms reach high. Ujjayi breath. So there's constant adjustments that we're making in the body. This is why this practice is so present, because you're always in your body present, making those strengthening adjustments. Inhale, root to rise. Exhale, forward fold, Uttanasana. Inhale, hands to shins, Ardha Uttanasana. Slowly step back, let's close this off with a Vinyasa flow. Step to plank, take an extra inhale. Option to bring the knees down, hug your elbows to the sides, body, 90. Inhale, shift forward. Now, option to come into up dog. You can't really see because I have really small arms, but I feel like T-Rex in this pose. If you want to do Urdhva Mukha Svanasana up dog, press the tops of the feet. Instead of keeping the hips down, the legs down like I am now in Bhujangasana, you lift the legs off the ground, slight squeezing the glutes to support. Then come through to down dog, breathe Ujjayi. We're putting this together, flowing this out 1 to 2 times, then we'll add on for the rest of our poses. Ujjayi breath. Modify as needed, take your time. I'm gonna move super slowly, probably slower than normal, just so that we can get these poses down. Asanas. Inhale, right leg. This time I want you to flex the heel, keep the hips squared. So instead of opening to a down dog split, we're gonna keep the hips squared. Gaze to the front, shift forward, draw the knee towards your nose, step into runner's lunge. You might have to scoot your foot up. Back knee is straight. Front knee is bent. Straighten out the front knee, bend the knee, draw the back knee down. Press into the front heel, release your back toe. Inhale, arms shoot high, squeeze the core, breathe. Keep breathing, you have an extra breath. Adjust the body. Notice what you're doing, stay focused. Inhale. Core strong, glutes strong. Easy twist. Exhale, left palm down, back heel comes up. Inhale, rotate from the obliques. Watch the shoulder blades, you have an extra breath here. So even though your left palm is down, you're still lifting out of the body. Knee to chest, breathe, ujjayi. Try not to pop your hips up. Swing the arm to the back of the room, step forward, toes touch, inhale, utkatasana chair. Exhale, sink low, on your inhale, press the heels, squeeze the glutes, stand tall. Forward fold. Inhale, half, bend the knees, step your right foot back, left leg high, flex the heel, three-legged dog. Remember, that's different from a split. The split has a little bit more open hip, not too open, right? We want to keep it slightly squared. The three-legged dog has a super closed hip. Stamp your heel, knee towards nose, shift forward, keep it strong into the core, and then step forward. Square your hips, extend the leg, one breath. Bend the knee, back knee comes down. Release the back toe, press into the front heel, squeeze the inner thighs. So we're not just like haphazardly moving in the body. We're so active, our bandhas are still strong, right? You're holding your tinkle, you're drawing the belly in, knitting your ribcage, reaching the arms up and engaging the glutes. Breathe, ujjayi breath. Easy twist, right palm down, watch your shoulder. Don't let it internally rotate, externally rotate. Left arm reaches high, breathe. You have an extra breath, press out of the right palm. Activate your right knee. Left knee is bent to 90. Swing the arms, step forward, toes touch. Inhale, utkatasana. Exhale, sit low, see your toes. Heart is up, inhale, roots arise. Hands to heart, take a moment. Woo! It's a lot. So we're gonna flow this out one more time, right and left. Breathing through your body as you flow. Grab some water if you need it. Anjali Mudra, Tadasana, Mountain Pose, hands to heart, breathe, ujjayi. Right and left, two times and we'll add on. Inhale, reach. Exhale. We're just gonna do one time actually. Inhale, lift, bend the knees. We're gonna flow this to Vinyasa. Step it back, Chaturanga, exhale. Inhale. Exhale, down dog. Find your breath, we're doing right side first. On your next inhale, right leg lifts, three leg. Knee to nose, crunch, shift forward, step through, straighten out the leg one time. Back knee down, Anjani Asana, release the toe, inhale. Easy twist. Maybe a bind this time, arm reaches behind. Utkatasana, front of the mat, step it through, inhale. Toes together, knees together, heavy tailbone, heart lifts. Sit low, stand tall, inhale. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, lift. Bend the knees, step your right foot back, left leg high, flex. Stamp the heel, knee to nose, shift. Step it through, straighten the leg. Back knee comes down, press into the front heel, inhale, reach, Anjani Asana. Easy twist, watch your shoulders, rotate from the obliques, inhale. Grab a bind, you have the extra breath. Utkatasana chair, inhale up, exhale, sit, inhale, root to rise. Vinyasa flow, exhale, inhale. Step to plate, bend the elbows as you get there. Exhale, chaturanga, one long line. Inhale, Urdhva Mukha. Exhale, Adho Mukha. Woo! Guys, give yourself a tap on the back. You just did another flow. Congratulations. We're starting to progress. So this is why it's called a practice. Every time you hit your mat, you get stronger. Sometimes you have off days, that's completely fine. That's part of the journey, right? It's just about coming back to this practice to strengthen the mind-body connection and to still your thoughts. So, let's take a breath. Open up, cleanse your exhale, let it go. One more. Let it go. Let's take a few seated cat-cow. Exhale, round the spine. Inhale, open up. Exhale, round the spine like someone's tickling you or punching you in the core. Hopefully nobody punches you in the belly. Energetically, left punch in the belly. Exhale, round. Sometimes I say things, guys, I don't know. Inhale, open up. Neutral spine, circle the neck, one direction, then the other. So we're going over a couple more poses. Warrior two, Trikonasana, and adding in that, we will do the easy twist again. So when we're doing this the first time, we're really gonna set it up, right? Set up the alignment in the body, set up the breath in the body, kind of break it down so that you can really get the mind-body connection, not just like, oh yeah, I'm in this pose, but no, I'm actively in this pose. I'm telling my heel to press. I'm telling my core to draw in, shoulder blades down, etc. That's really what we're doing in these poses, is we're just actively, mindfully being in tune with our body. Adho Mukha Svanasana. Let's see if you can get there before I tell you what it is. Adho Mukha Svanasana. Down dog. Plank to down dog. Breathe ujjayi breath, remembering the shoulder blades. Try not to do this. Shoulders to ears, you wanna stay away from that. You wanna draw the shoulder blades down and away from the ears, activating your lats so your entire backside body starts to activate to get those shoulder blades away from the ears. You're not really pulling down. We never really wanna pull our muscles down. We wanna activate them, engage them, maybe even melt. Ujjayi breath. If this is a hardcore pose, you're building strength, mind over matter in all of this. If you're feeling pain, step away from it. Inhale your right leg high to a down dog split. So a little bit open hip, not fully open, right? We still want a slight close. Exhale, runner's lunge. So my mat has a line down the middle. Pretend like your mat has a line down the middle, yes? From here, we're pivoting the left heel down into a slight 45. So not full blow 90, that's gonna hurt the knee a bit, but a gentle 45, in between 45 and 60 degree angle. So check back, look at your foot. Now just for this one moment, I want you to look at your front heel and start to step your heel back to see where it is on your opposite foot. I'm gonna come up. So my heel, my back heel is at a 45 degree angle. In other words, we're not out to a 90, we're not into parallel. We're just in between 45 to 60. That's gonna allow your hips to be diagonal, you'll see. Right foot comes, the heel should be right in the middle of your inner arch of your back foot. That is the placement of warrior two. Notice my hips here. If I was facing forward, right, I'm completely stacked forward to you. That is not warrior two. That's more like a low lunge, our Anjani Asana. Hips are squared, right? This is more of a diagonal. So in order to do so, I have to have my back heel at a 45 to 60, my front toes facing directly forward, so facing you right now, and my hips are at a diagonal. Then when we're opening up our arms, our entire body stays active and we're just rotating our head. That's pretty much how we do it. So it's a lot of isolation, isolated positioning in the body, all one connection in the body. So your right leg is forward. I'm gonna face this way so you can see forward instead of my back. So your right leg is forward. Let's come back to down dog. You stay facing the exact same way you are. I'm gonna face the opposite so you can see me. From here, you're stepping your right foot forward all the way in between your hands. So it should be towards the inside of your right thumb, not stepping on it, right? Just a little bit on the inside. Pivot your back heel to a 45 degree to 60 degree angle. Look at it. Just look at it. Would you just look at it? Inner arch slightly lifts, outer edge of your foot presses down. Now I want you to squeeze the core, the glutes and the core slightly. As you lift the body up, windmill the top arm to the back, extend your right arm. Now just straighten your legs for a moment. Check your positioning. Your heel is in line with your inner arch. Your back heel roots down. The outer edge of the foot roots down. Your big toe is down, yes? Activate through the kneecap. So we're not dumping in the knee here. This is super important to keep the knee active. Right above your kneecap, your quad, made up of four muscles, hence the name, quad. That engages completely. From here, your front knee is bent to a 90-ish degree angle, meaning your right knee is directly over your right ankle. Now, when you're starting, you might be here, that's okay, right? What we don't want is this. It's gonna strain the knee over time. So even if you're a little bit gently off, but you have the bent knee over the ankle until you strengthen out your body, that's fine. Eventually, you want to find length. So even though it seems like I'm pushing away with my feet, I'm not pushing away. I'm actually drawing inward. So it's almost like you're gripping the mat and pulling the front mat in towards the center, pulling the back of the mat in towards the center. Once you get the energy to center, then you activate your bandhas. Draw the energy up. Squeeze like you're holding your tinkle. Draw the belly in, ribcage to spine, yes? Front knee bends nice and deep. Now watch your torso. Remember the hips are diagonal? They're not straight, right? They're not square. They're slightly diagonal. From here, core stays active, arms come out. Watch those shoulders, they're not here. Let them gently melt down, activating through your lats. Breathe, inhale. Exhale. Look towards the front of your palm, engaging energy through your fingertips so we're not like melting these wrists. We're actively shooting out. Energy through your fingertips, bend the knee. Now draw the energy up and in. Breathe. Your gaze is beyond your right fingertips. Stay there. Coming towards the front to face you. Breathe. Virabhadrasana 2. So watch those shoulders. Make sure they're not here. Roll back. Shoulder blades in. Rib cage knits. You're probably dying, so let's get out of this pose. From here, start to press into the front heel. Straighten out your right leg. Extend your top arm up, 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 up. And you're just going to slightly bring your left palm to the back of the thigh. Never press down. You don't want to add pressure to the body, right? We're just slightly using this for support. Maybe the hand reaches down. This is reverse Trikonasana, shoulders back. As you exhale, sass your left hip back. Stay there. I'm going to face this way. So you're sassing the hip back. It's almost like sass, 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 right? Draw the hip back to the back of the room, back of the room, back of the room, back of the room. Keep extending with the top arm. Reach until you can't reach any further. Legs are straight. This is where the block comes in handy. My block, I like to bring it behind my calf. Press my palm down. Make sure you're stacked. Extend the top arm to the front of the room. Top of the room. Breathe. See, your neck is an extension of your body, right? Your head is an extension of your neck and your spine. So we're not here. Your neck isn't dead. It's active. It's going to strain the first few times you're building muscles. So stay and breathe and strain and strengthen. Press out of the right shoulder. Externally rotate the shoulder. So we're not inward. We're out. Rotate from your right oblique towards the sky. Now you want to have a flat back as though you're in between two planes of glass. So if I was here, right, you wouldn't be able to really see a rounded spine or an arched back, right? You're just a flat back right there. So the goal is to have the knees straight. Maybe you're here. That's okay. Give yourself some patience. Listen, this is tough, right? It's not easy, but it's easy. Everybody would do it. Everybody should do it. Straighten out, belly in, breathe. This is Trikonasana, triangle pose. How many triangles can you see here? A few, right? Draw the core in, breathe. You have another big breath in, another deep breath out. Bend the front knee. Remember, I'm facing opposite right now, but stay where you are. Bend the front knee, reverse warrior two, palavrita, virabhadrasana two. Bend the front knee, extend your top arm to the back of the room, reach your right arm up towards the back of the room. Big extension. Remember, we're not dumping here, we're just resting. Inhale, start to windmill the arms down towards the ground. Pivot your back heel up, step your right foot back. Now you're in plank. Inhale, bend the elbows to chaturanga. Shift forward, open up the heart space. Down dog, Adho Mukha Svanasana. Take a break. Good job. Coming into our opposite side, Virabhadrasana, Paravrita, Trikonasana, Trikonasana, Paravrita, Virabhadrasana. So, warrior two, reverse triangle, triangle, reverse warrior two. That's our flow. It's pretty simple. Let's go through our left side. Down dog, Adho Mukha Svanasana, engaging your breath, ujjayi pranayama. Victorious breath work. Left leg, inhale, flex. Step to the front of the mat. Remember, you're stepping right in the middle of your body, closer towards your left thumb. So we're not completely on the outer edge, we're sort of in the train track, right on the track. Pivot your back heel to a 45. Take a moment, step your foot back. Is your left heel into the inner arch of your right foot? If not, adjust it. Maybe you need to come back to down dog and try that again. From here, on your inhale, press the right heel down the outer edge of your right foot. Windmill the arm up, squeeze the inner thighs. This is not an easy pose, guys. This is very difficult, so give yourself some time. Bend deep in the front knee. Check your body, look at your body. Are you doing things right? The back heel should be the furthest point on your mat. So that means that you're angling your toes slightly forward towards 45 to 60 versus 90 or beyond. Outer edge of your back foot presses down. Big toe presses down. Inner arch of your right foot lifts up slightly, engaging through the quads. Remember your core muscles right in here. All of this lifts up. Belly button draws in. Front knee is bent deep to a 90. Even if you're here, try to bend. Try to find length though. Woo! Front toes, try not to roll inward. It's gonna destroy your knee. Keep pressing to the outer edge. Bend the knee, draw the energy. Remember, we're pulling inward, then up towards the crown of the head. Bandhas are active. Your mula bandha, pelvic floor. Uddiyana bandha, belly in. Arms reach out. Try not to let the shoulders come outward. Let them melt down. Breathe. Ujjayi breath. This is engaged. All of this is engaged. Your lats, your core, your serratus. Everything is active. Your neck is long. Through the crown of the head, gazing forward. Fingertips. Breathe. Inhale. Now before you come into reverse trikonasana, reverse triangle, I want you to feel actively pressing into the front heel. Squeeze your left glute, then you can lift up. It's gonna help support your body. Inhale. Exhale, trikonasana. Right hip draws back, 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 back. Keep the legs straight, grab your block. Bring it behind your calf. Extend the right arm. So you'll see some people doing it in front. For me, this to me feels like I'm drawing my shoulder forward, trying to get stacked over. Whereas here, I can really open up my body. If I did not have my block, I would have my right palm in front of my calf. Some people like to bring their palm to rest on their shin. I feel like people get lazy and start to dump on their shin, which can destroy your knee over time. Really opening up, pressing up. So the block is good to start to enhance. Flatten out the spine, rotating from your bottom oblique towards the sky. It's almost like your left oblique and your left eyeball gaze towards your right thumb. Watch your shoulders. Ujjayi, core still strong, legs are straight. Option to soften the front knee, but you really want to try to work for that. Try to squeeze your inner thighs. On your inhale, bend the front knee. Reverse warrior two. Parabrita Virabhadrasana. Windmill the arms, pivot the back heel, find plank, inhale, exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, option for up dog or cobra, exhale, down dog. Woo! Take a moment. All right, we're gonna flow that out, right and left, so we can get Trikonasana and the warrior two down. So, big breath in and out. We're almost done, guys. Breathe. I might even have a part three, just because there's so much. You can also take a 200-hour yoga training so you can learn all this stuff. Inhale, right, sorry, come to down dog, breathe. Inhale, right leg high. Step it to the front in between your palms. So I have to kind of lift my body up to get my leg forward. Pivot the back heel. Press into the front heel, open up, windmill the arms out. Warrior two, Virabhadrasana. Stay for a moment. Adjust the body as needed. Shoulders back, core strong, back heel rooted. Press into the front heel, inhale, reverse, Trikonasana. Exhale, Trikonasana, draw the hip forward, option for block. Breathe. Bend the front knee, inhale, option for a bind, reverse, warrior two. On your exhale, take it through, windmill the arms, step your right foot back, chaturanga, option for knees. Inhale, lift, exhale back. Find your breath. Vama, inhale, exhale. Pivot, inhale, breathe, warrior two. Hold for a moment. ujjayi. Reverse, trikonasana, press, inhale. Exhale, trikonasana, extend, 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 flatten out the spine, rotate the obliques. Option for a reverse, warrior two with a bind. Bend the knee, inhale, reach up and back, big breath. Windmill the arms, step your left foot back, chaturanga. Option for knees, exhale, inhale. Let's do that one more time, guys. Big breath in, deep breath out. One more, option to open up the mouth if you're overheated. Let's blow this out, right and left. Inhale, right leg. Exhale, step. Back heel, inhale, warrior two. Exhale, sit low, hold. You have an extra breath. Reverse, trikonasana. Exhale, trikonasana. Option for block or ground. Inhale, reverse, warrior two. Windmill chaturanga. Adho Mukha, exhale, Shavasana. Inhale, lift. Runners. Heel, inhale, you have an extra breath. Virabhadrasana 2. Watch your hips, watch your heel. Reverse, Trikonasana, inhale, reverse, triangle. Exhale, triangle, Trikonasana, flatten out the spine, rotate. Reverse, warrior 2, inhale. Find yourself in child's pose. Hands down, step back. Exhale, inhale. Child's pose, knees together this time, release. Woo! Nice work, guys. Relax. Grab your palms behind, extend towards the sky. Take a nice big stretch. If you need to release the hands to roll up, that's fine. Otherwise, tuck your chin, start to roll up. Inhale, lift the heart. Tuck your chin, hands to knees, round the spine. Let's do some cool down poses. We didn't really do this last time. We're going to do a few now. Woo! All right, when you're ready, lazy man's transition onto your glutes. Soles of the feet together. I think we did this one last time, actually. Soles of the feet together. Draw the heels towards your groin. The further away they are, the easier this pose is, right? So you kind of just like find a diamond shape. I like to be a little bit more intense here. You can also sit on a block if you're not planning on going forward so that you can find length in the spine and let the knees really open. That's a great option. Stay here. Or, and if you don't have a block, you can use a blanket or a pillow. Otherwise, find length in your spine, integrity through the tailbone all the way to the crown of the head. Inhale. Hinge from the hips, you want to slightly flatten out the spine as much as you can. Maybe that means you stay here. Listen, that's fine, stay there. You'd rather have integrity of your body than here. It's gonna get you nowhere. So maybe you're here. Maybe you're ready for more. You want to walk the hands forward. Hands can stay down. When you're ready, flatten out, then release. Option to press the knees open if you want more. Be patient with your body. Let's take three ujjayi breath here. Remember, the exhales are equally as important as the inhales. Slowly start to roll it up. Find integrity of the spine. Janushirshasana. That literally means head to knee pose. So you might see Janushirshasana standing, sitting. There's a lot of variations for Janu. We're doing it the way I like it. So traditionally, Janu would have a leg straight. I like to kind of open up my hip a little bit so that I can rotate, and then I find a deep twist in my spine. That's me. But you can always just stay here. Left palm down, right arm high. Start to reach forward, forward. Maybe you just grab a block and bring your head to the block here. Just try to watch your shin. Don't press on the knee. Either on your thigh, maybe on your shin, not all of your weight on there, right? Maybe even off of your leg, just to be safe. I don't know. And then you can just relax here. Option to draw your left palm, right hand to the outer edge of your left foot. Rotate so that the shoulders are parallel, then draw yourself down. If you want to do it with a little more open hip like I like,
Just open up the right knee so that you're more diagonal out. Then you can really rotate from the right side. Right arm reaches high. Grab the outer edge of your left foot. Rotate. So I'm pressing my left hand down so that I can rotate. Then I can release down. Keep pressing your left palm down. Notice the shift in the shoulders. Active yogi toes. Stretching out the hamstring. Breathe. Guys, you might be here. That's fine. Just slide up the side. Let's take one more breath. Slowly lift it up. Go ahead and bend the knees to front. Open up the back. So hands come back. Fingertips face forward. Feet are at a hip distance. Press into the heels. Lift up. Let's take a nice deep breath in. Close into my groin, so I'm not low, I'm right in right there. Option to stay forward, or option to open up a little bit. Take whatever your body needs, and then open up a little bit. Rotate the body. Left arm reaches, right arm down. I'm rotating through my obliques. Right, little swivel stick. Exhale, reach to the outer edge of your right foot. Rotate, release. Maybe you're just forward right here. That's fine. Keep pressing into the back palm. Keep rotating through the obliques. Yogi toes. That means that your toes flex towards your nose. Try to get the pinky to touch your nose. Breathe. Ujjayi breath. Slowly unwind. Inhale. Ball of knees in the chest. Give yourself a nice big hug. Inhale. Lift up the heart. Open up. Slowly start to find yourself on your back. Relax all the way down. Give yourself a hug. Knees to chest. Maybe lift the chin up. Slowly release down, feet on the ground. Let's find a gentle windshield wipe in the knees, a little side to side, just to let the spine go. Breathe. We're almost there. Supta Baddha Konasana. Recline, bound angle pose. So we already did bound angle. Seated. Now we're going to do reclined. Feet come towards each other, knees open up nice and wide. I like to tuck my tailbone under. Shoulder blades down. Hands to your inner thighs, take a deep breath in. Let it go. If this is far too much, guys, grab your blocks, bring them underneath your thighs, and just let the knees hang down. But really, you want to find a little bit of extension. Breathe in and out. Ujjayi. Start to extend the arms up. Extend the legs forward. Let's take a big body stretch. Inhale. Slowly relax. Let it go. Almost done. Bend the knees. Feet on the ground. Tuck your tailbone so your spine is flat. Left leg comes up. Reach up. Grab your foot with your hand. Maybe you have a strap or a towel. Or you can grab your calf. Otherwise, bend the knee to the outer edge of your left side body. It's coming towards the armpit. How happy baby. Ardha Ananda Balasana. Slowly lift back up. Again, you have this option here. Circle the wrist, circle the ankle a few times. Breathe. If you want more, draw the foot closer to your nose.
Help me brand new in the side and step
wind. So we release, let's switch sides. Right leg up. Options for your grab.
Like I said already,
bend deep into the right knee, draw it towards the ground, and the outer edge by your armpit, release down.
No, you'll stay.
You gotta keep your left hip stable. Ananda Balasana, Ardha Ananda, half happy. So we extend back towards the sky, grab your options, circle the ankle. So we're just drawing a little bit of mobility here for the front of the leg, of the foot rather. Ananda Balasana. Both legs up. Grab the outer edges of your feet as you bend the knees. Your elbows stay to the inside of your inner thighs. Bend the knees nice and deep. Start to rock. Watch your tailbone. Don't let it lift. Tailbone roots. Side to side. If you want more, maybe grab the inner arches and then open up your legs. Tailbone down. Slowly release, feet on the ground. Let's reverse that just a bit to get the front hip open. Palms down, hips stretch, open up. Hips up, squeeze the glutes. Just give your front side a little, set, a little time to release. And then slowly relax. Last little bit. Right leg straight, left knee into your chest. Couple of hugs, circle them out. Draw the knee over to your right side, come onto your right hip. I like to adjust and then open up the shoulder. Left shoulder tries to flatten to the ground. So you're rotating, you're twisting your spine, you're detoxing your inner organ. Knees left. Guys, if you like this playlist, it's on my Spotify. It's called Vin for Vinyasa. Rebound.
What to do, what to do. Well, that's all I can want.
Nice detoxification of the spine, of the inner organs. Find your breath. Start to unwind. First, find your spine on the ground. Right knee to chest, left leg straightened out. Now you can keep your left foot bent, that's fine. Or left knee bent. Give yourself a few hugs, little circles. Your right knee comes all the way over to your left side, so I'm pressing into my elbow to get me over onto your side hip. Rotate, then extend your right arm out. Try to flatten out your right shoulder. So you're actively rotating through your center core. Breathe. Gaze to the opposite shoulder, right shoulder. Breathe, ujjayi breath. So I'm gently pressing my right knee down so that I can really feel it on my outer edge of my hip, into my spine, finding this healthy spinal twist. Rotations of the spine. It's like you're wringing out a towel and you're really adding mobility and release into the spine. But try not to overdo it. If you feel pain, guys, you don't ever want pain, right? You want discomfort. Embrace that discomfort. From there, you find a little bit of release, a little bit of space, but you never want pain. So kind of know the difference between what that means for you. Take one more big breath in. Wide. Spine down, feet on the ground. One more hip opener, sorry, frontal line opener just to kind of reverse that. Lift the hips, press the palms, and then slowly relax. Windshield wipe the knees side to side. Breathe, ujjayi breath. Start to find yourself in our resting pose or ending pose. Extend the legs to the front of the mat. Relax the shoulders down, the palms face up. This is the most delicious, most amazing, most important pose of your entire class. So guys, if you don't have time to go through the whole thing, this is probably around 60, 65 minutes, then I highly recommend whatever you do, just to make sure you get a little bit of a shavasana in your body. Gentle kiss of the shoulder blades, palms face up. Relax the fingertips, the wrists. Maybe shake, wiggle a little bit just to get the kinks out. Gentle tuck in the chin. Close the eyes. If you have a hard time closing your eyes, bring something over your eyes, something that will kind of let them fold out. Take a big breath in. Open up the mouth, exhale out. Two more cleansing breaths. Let this really melt you down. Big inhale, expand through the chest. Feel a sip of all the goodness in your environment. Then as you exhale, release, cleanse out your body. Let yourself soften down. Shavasana. One more inhale. Exhale, soften, relax, release. I will guide you out of this. So if you have time, enjoy Shavasana with me and I will guide you out.
Your body in this space. Come back to the physical. Take an inhale, breathe. Let it go. Start to wiggle the fingertips and the toes, drawing awareness back into your physical body. Being gentle as you come back to the space. Maybe circle the wrists, the ankles. Take an inhale, reach the arms forward, point the toes, like you're just waking up, a big morning yawn in the body, breathe. And then soften the elbows, gentle bend in the knees, little tuck of a tailbone. Take a rock side to side, meet me on either side, either bicep, fetal position, right side, maybe a little bit more drawing of the energy. Left side, maybe a little bit more releasing, relaxing energy. Fetal position. Gently press yourself up to a seated position. I like to sit on my block sometimes. Just let my spine lengthen. Hands to the knees. Take your time. Close the eyes. Ujjayi breaths, one more time, inhale. beautiful practice is a journey that takes you through the body. It's ever changing, ever supporting. There's always something new to learn within yourself, within your body, within the environment that surrounds your world. And this practice is more than just a workout, it's a work in. It allows us to release some thoughts, to relax that process, to focus on what truly matters, which is the present moment. It's our breath, it's our physical wellness, physical emotional wellness, our well-being. Ending class with me with the bumblebee breath. So this is very similar to an ujjayi breath, but we're keeping our mouth closed for this, for the bumblebee breath. Keeping the mouth closed, unclench your jaw. Release the tongue from the roof of the mouth, let your body kind of release down. As you exhale, as though you're oming your breath out, we're gonna hum the breath so that you can feel the vibration in your heart space. So first, let's set up the breath, let's cleanse the body. Inhale, arms big, reach. Exhale, hands in a heart center. One more time, big breath, inhale. Exhale, palms to heart space. On this next exhale, bumblebee breath, inhale through the nose. It is an honor to be able to draw this energy in from me to you. One more bumblebee breath, inhale. To be able to guide you through this practice of discovery, this practice of release, self-love, this practice that brings me so much joy and hopefully starts to bring you joy if it hasn't already. As we end class, we proudly and beautifully say Namaste, and Namaste translates to the light in me honors, respects the light and dark in you. Dark in me as well. Thank you for flowing with me, for maybe trying something new, for taking the time to take a few steps back from a power vinyasa or dance fitness class or kickboxing or whatever it is that you've been doing, just to take a few steps back to find the foundation. I appreciate you. Stay healthy, stay safe. Namaste. Thank you, guys.